ChatGPT has taken Europe by storm, be it to draft emails, write research papers, or explain complex topics. This has already resulted in multiple reactions. In March, Europol, the EU's anti-crime agency, has voiced its concern about potential criminal exploitation of ChatGPT's capabilities. Then in May, Italy initiated a temporary ban on ChatGPT in an effort to enhance the protection of personal data. And today, the European Union is discussing the EU AI Act, which aims to set rules for AI in the European market. These developments are contributing to a mounting transatlantic dispute over the governance of the technology, with OpenAI, the innovator behind ChatGPT, warning the European Union that the forthcoming EU AI Act could force ChatGPT to leave the EU. So what is this new European Union AI Act? The Act wants to ensure a human-centric and ethical development of artificial intelligence in Europe, and aims to introduce a common regulatory and legal framework. Basically, the Act classifies AI into four levels of risk, with each level requiring a different degree of regulation. Level 1 is minimal risk, which encapsulates the majority of programs. Think of AI-enabled video games and spam filters. These require no EU intervention. At level 2, there's limited risk. AI systems falling into this category include deepfakes and chatbots. Their compliance obligations are limited and focus on transparency. The user needs to be informed that they are dealing with an AI system, unless it is obvious on the face of it. Then at level 3, we have high risk, which means AI programs used in transport, education, health, safety, law enforcement, and other sectors. Think of an AI designed to help with surgery or self-driving cars. These AI systems must undergo rigorous risk assessment, use high-quality datasets to minimize risk and bias, maintain activity logs for traceability, provide comprehensive documentation for regulatory compliance, and ensure clear user information and human oversight measures. And then there's level 4, unacceptable risk. For example, social scoring, where individuals are ranked based on certain behaviors or characteristics. Perhaps the most well-known example is China's social credit system, where people earn or lose points for things the government thinks are good or bad, like paying bills on time, donating to charity, jaywalking, or posting negative things online. These scores can change what people can do, like whether they can travel, get a loan, or even where their kids go to school. These AI systems will be strictly banned in the EU. So into which risk category does ChatGPT fall? ChatGPT is usually put in the level 2 limited risk group for chatbots. But there are new discussions in the European Parliament about adding rules for models like ChatGPT. These include forcing tech companies to share details about copyrighted data used in training, which would allow artists and others to try and claim compensation for the use of their material, and making sure the model doesn't create illegal content. This has obviously annoyed the US tech firms, with ChatGPT suggesting that it could leave the continent, and Google CEO meeting prominent EU politicians to lobby for regulation that does not stifle innovation. So what next? The EU is keen to move forward and is taking a two-pronged approach. Firstly, it is developing a voluntary AI pact, together with Google, to try and stop misinformation that could influence the upcoming election next year. Secondly, it will continue to work on the EU AI Act with the four levels of risk, which still need to be ratified by the Council of the European Union, and therefore will likely be introduced no earlier than next year. Nonetheless, the EU believes it can lead the world when it comes to AI regulation. But what do you think? Are these four levels of AI regulation the right approach? Let us know in the comments. And please like the video and subscribe to our channel. And if you wish to support us further, please consider signing up to Patreon.